Did you ever wonder how you can pick a random item from a list inside of IntegraMAT or just generate a random number? Then this video is for you. Hi, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of Techflow AI, and in this video I will show you exactly how you can create a random selector inside of IntegraMAT with multiple ways and multiple options, from very simple to set up to far more advanced approach where you can have like a full dynamic list and do these kind of things. Alright, so we jump right into it. First, I have created already a scenario for you that you can look up over here. So we have quite complex formula which looks quite complicated, but I will go through it one by one. Basically what we try to achieve here is we have three different hashtags here: love, Instagood, and photo of the day, which are like the top three hashtags on Instagram, and we want to randomly pick one of them when we post something to Instagram. So how can we do that? We do that by using this small helper formula, which is called floor and then random and all these kind of different values. And here we just have to replace the max value with the max number that we want to get out, and the min value with the min number we want to get out. So in our case, the max would be 3 because we have 3 hashtags that we want to look for, and the min value is 1. So I replace it with a 1 and also this one with a 1. And now this formula will generate a random number between 1 and 3 every time. All right, every time you run this scenario. Then inside of this tool, or this set variable tool, we have a switch function. The switch function basically has an input value, and then if I hover over the function, you can see exactly how the structure is. So it has an expression. In our case, it will be the function that I just showed you, which will create one random number between 1 and 3. And then we check the value. If it's 1, then we want to have as a result hashtag 1. If it's 2, then as a result we want to have hashtag 2. And if it's 3, we want to have hashtag 3. And that way it will output hashtag 1, 2, or 3 based on our random number that we input with the formula that I showed before. So how that looks like, I will just run it once and then we can check the output. So the output of this one is love. Here is a random number that we picked. So the random number in this case is 2. That might not necessarily be the second one here. Yeah, it's 1 because this in here generates a different random number. We could also like layer it, but that's too complicated for now and we don't need it because we can directly put it all inside of that module. So the next step would only be to have your Instagram set up, like have your page connected at the photo URL that you want to post. You can have it from other sources. I will show you in a second how to do that. And then you can have your caption and a hashtag where you can just use the hashtag that you generated before, which is one of the random ones that you have created here. Now you could add like a list of 100 hashtags right in here and it would still work and would pick always one of them. Just make sure that you increase your max items to whatever the amount of hashtags is that you're going to use. So this is it for the easy part. Now let's get into the a little bit more advanced parts, the intermediate part, let's say it like that. That is for having new files uploaded on Dropbox, for example, and then picking a random hashtag or a random item and then posting it to Instagram. So we make use of the check new files and folder Dropbox module, which will trigger whenever there's a new file inside of a specific folder. Then we have to get the direct image URL so we can actually use it inside of the Instagram module. Then we're doing the exact same thing that we did before. So we're generating a random hashtag with this random function that we created. And finally, we post it on Instagram. We use the download URL from this module here. And then we add the hashtag. Now, this is all good, but usually on Instagram, we wanna have like a full list of items, or we wanna pick a coupon code out of a full list of items randomly, or we wanna randomly choose a winner. So we wanna randomly pick like one item of a full list or multiple items of a full list. What I've prepared for you is a list of the top 100 hashtags on Instagram currently, and you can find it on a Google sheet. It's with the ID and the hashtag. I will put a share link so you can make a copy of this one down below the video, so you can just like look at it and copy it and use it for yourself. And now we want to pick a certain amount, for example, 5 hashtags out of this list randomly, and we want to use it on Instagram. And we also want to make sure that we're not having any duplicates in it. So this is the way that we can do that. So we have the check new files and folder from the previous scenario, then we download it, and then we have this middle part here where we have a repeater. We pick a random hashtag, then we combine the hashtags all into one string. Then we remove the duplicates with some advanced functions, integument functions. And then finally, we post it to Instagram with a complete list. So for the repeater, we can set it to the amounts of hashtags we want to have in our list at the end. So the initial value is always 1, and then we can repeat it to like how many times we want to search for or pick a random hashtag. It could be 1, it could be 29, could be 30, 200, whatever. So of course it depends on how long your list is, and the more hashtags you want to get out, the more duplicates you might have. So in this case, in this scenario, it could be less than 5 if we set it to 5, because if there are 2 duplicates, we'll just remove 1. You could probably expand this scenario to always make sure that you have always 5 hashtags, but as far as I know, that's not good anyways for the Instagram algorithm, so you should have like a variable amount of hashtags anyways. All right, so the next step is to pick random hashtags out of our list. And how do we do that? We connect the search roles module of Google Sheets. Then we select sheet 1, which is in our case the one with the ID and the hashtags. And then we set up for the filter the ID, which is the first column, equal to, and then our random number. So that is the exact same formula that we have used before, which will generate a random number between 1 and 100. Remember, so this is the max value, this is the min value, and this is also the min value. So you replace that with whatever value you want to get out, and the maximum number of returned rows should only be 1. And then it will give out one row where the ID is exactly the ID matching here with a random number. So the next step is to use the text aggregator module with the following settings. So as the source module, we want to have a repeater. Then for row separator, we want to have other, and then we put a space here, because hashtags are usually separated by a space. You could even do like, if you just have a list with words without the hashtag symbol, you could use a space and then this one, and that will like create or add this symbol before every hashtag, the hashtag symbol. But you'd have to make sure that the first word gets that hashtag as well, because it will only add the separator in between the words. All right, so we don't have to use the group by, we don't want to stop the processing, and then we just map the hashtag out of our Google Sheets. So we just click on it, and that will it will be in here. I will show you in a second how this looks like. And then we also want to remove duplicates. And how do we do this? We can use some of the integument functions, which are super powerful, by the way. And if you want to learn more about these, I've created an integument functions cheat sheet, which will guide you through all of the available integument functions. And you can learn more about them and how to use them, because they are super powerful. As you can see, I've used a bunch of them inside of this scenario, and yeah, they are free to use, so they don't count as operations. So I really recommend to look into the integument functions and use them as much as possible. Now let's get into the functions that are being used here. First, I'm splitting up the text, so the output that I've generated before, by the space. So then I create an array. With the array, I can use the distinct function to remove any duplicates that are in the array. And then afterwards, I just join it back together into text string with separated by a space. So these are these three functions, what they are doing. It works from inside out. So it's first doing the split, then remove the duplicates, and then it joins it back together. And the final output is what we want to have on Instagram. So this is what we have here, the Instagram list. Now let's set that, for example, to 10. We want to have 10 hashtags inside on Instagram. And now let's run it once. You can see now it repeats it 10 times, it searches 10 times the Google Sheet and outputs it in a combined list, like combine hashtags into string. Then it removes the duplicates and finally posts it on Instagram. So the output of the repeater, it just counts up 10 times. And then Google Sheet module returns 10 different hashtags, for example, the random ID 27 and tags for likes. Then let's look at this one, random ID 6, TBT. And the full hashtags that got generated are these ones. And by the text aggregator, they got combined into a list with spaces separated. So this list is actually already looking pretty good and we could use it directly in Instagram, but we want to make sure that we are not using any hashtags twice. So that is where this one is coming in. In this case, we don't have any duplicate hashtags, so it won't remove anything. But in case you have multiple or two times the same hashtag, it will remove them. And finally, it will post it on Instagram. Let's refresh the page and you can see the post is here. And we have the caption, here's a caption, and below the hashtag list, and we have all the hashtags. You can also use that to mention people, so with the at symbol you can tag other people or other accounts. And somebody already liked it, so yeah. That's how you can use Integromat to create like a random generator of items. And you can also use that to pick a random ID. So if you just like get out this one single module, you can pick a random item out of a Google Sheets list, for example, with coupon codes. And then you can have another condition. Let's say this would be a coupon code, coupon delivered. Let's do it like this and make it bold. And then as a condition, we add an additional condition. And I have to refresh my sheet because I made changes. So it loads the new column header. So I want to add another rule. If coupon delivered not equal to, case insensitive, yes. What I want to make sure here is that every coupon is only delivered once. So I run this once and now it generates like the ID 40 and the hashtag is sun. And then I could have like a separate module, update a row. I want to update the module and say, okay, this hashtag, or like in the case of the example, so people won't get the same coupon code two times. So select the row number of our search here. And then we just say, okay, coupon delivered is yes. And then if you run it now again, like rename it, always rename it. That's a really good tip that I have for you to keep organized, as well as for the scenario names. I have a separate video which you can watch. I will link it in the description below, which is about how to keep organized or how to stay organized on Integromat. So we want to pick random hashtags and we want to add delivered status. So like this. And now if we run it once, you can see, okay, we got the ID, random ID 91, and it's handmade. And then it updates this row. If we check it now on the Google Sheet, row 91, or row 92 actually, with the ID 91, we update it with yes, which means right now this will not be picked anymore because we have that additional filter that this column should not be equal to yes. So this one here, coupon delivered should not be equal to yes. All right, so I hope that helped. And of course, if you want to make it even more dynamic, you could add a value over here from one of your previous module to like randomize the range of it. You can even use the same function that you've used here. One second, it's in here. The flow function, which generates a random number. You could even use that inside of the repeater to have a random amount of repeatings. So if we copy this one and paste it in here and say, okay, we want to have hashtags from 29, or let's say 11 to 29, and put the min value here as well. Remember, this is this function here, pick random number 311. So right now this will pick a random number between 11 and 29 and then pick that many hashtags out of your Google Sheet. All right, so that is super helpful. And the same could go for the actual amount of items that you want to search through in your list. So you can always like map that value, like max value over here. This one, you could get it from a previous module where you're looking up how many rows you have first filled in your random hashtag generator. And then you can get that amount, like that number, and you could put it in here. So you always get a dynamic range that you want to work with. All right, I hope that helped and you found a ton of value out of this video and know how to create random or get random hashtags or create a random string generator. You can use that for any kind of string. It's super easy to set up once you've understood it, and you can just like use that for many use cases. Especially this little formula is really helpful in many cases to generate random numbers between a certain, like random between two numbers. If you liked all these setups and want to learn more about the integermat functions, just go to the link below and get my integermat functions cheat sheet, where I will explain everything you need to know about the integermat functions and how they work. Thank you very much for watching.